Flying demonstration of the day. It's always nice, isn't it, when your only choice of seats is about whether you sit in the sun or not.
Other than that,
we're actually pretty chilled out, and hopefully you'll enjoy seeing some of our birds fly, including this one here. One of my favourite birds to see fly here at the castle for a number of different reasons. The main one being that Sage, this is Sage, is a tawny owl and a very, very prolific species actually across the United Kingdom. In actual fact, our most common species of owl to the UK. Woodland, you'll usually hear tweet, and then you'll hear another owl responding to woo. And it's not been scientifically proven, but I've got a hunch that it is the female calling the male a tweet, not the other way around. But if you walk through the woodlands here this afternoon, especially if you do get the opportunity, go up to the bluebell woods, because they're absolutely beautiful at the moment. And we know there's tawny owls nesting up in that direction.
Variety of owls that we've got. And I'd like to introduce to you the smallest owls we've got here at Muncaster. So everyone, please meet Lenford and Christy. Now these are burrowing owls. These guys actually come from America. They're very similar to our little owls that we have here in the UK. So do you all know what I mean when I say a little owl? Kind of. So little owls look just like this. That's what they're called. They're called little owls. And it's basically the British version of this. So they look very similar. These guys are more brown in colour, whereas little owls are more sort of grey colour. Now, what I want to show you guys is how fast they can run. So they've been blessed with these lovely long legs. I'm a little bit jealous. They've got these gorgeous long legs, and they're very, very quick on their legs. So what I want to show you, now they always cheat. We'll try and have a race. Christy, would you like to join us? What are you looking at? Come on. So we'll try and have a race. It doesn't always work. There we go, Linford's in the lead. Keep going. Christy's cheating. Linford, keep going. Good boy. Right, we're going to take them home. I'm going to try and reclaim my burrow and owl. Linford, would you like to go home? I'm going to put you away first. This is always tricky because it's getting the right one in the right box. It's impossible sometimes. Linford, I want you to go first. There we go. Not so bad today. If you get two in the one box, it's a nightmare.
This is a bird who goes by the name of Covelli. And what a bird. He's an enormous species, and actually Africa's largest species of owl. Weighing in today, just over 4 pounds in weight, but has roughly a 5.5 foot wingspan from tip to tip and across his shoulders. He's an enormous bird, and also has one of the longest lists of prey items of any species of bird of prey, let alone owl. And the owls, because they are fluffy, are somehow cute and cuddly. And they are very, very far from cute and cuddly. This is a bird that is designed to catch not only those grubs, beetles and insects, mice, voles and shrews that you might expect owls to be able to catch. This bird can pluck a fully grown vervet monkey by its head from the top of the tree and eat it for breakfast. It's incredibly powerful.
Well, awesome. Would you like to join us and show everyone what you are? I think that was a no. Diego? Maybe we should have stuck to the owls then. Come on then, thank you very much. This everyone, their lovely kookaburra. This is Diego. She's actually a blue-winged kookaburra. You can see why she's called a blue-winged kookaburra. She's got this lovely blue wing. She's that red tail. Shows you that she's a female, whereas males have a blue tail. So we know this is a girl. She's about 4 or 5 years old now. Could be here all day killing this snake. And that's the thing about a rubber snake, it never dies. So I'm gonna trade her off, hopefully. Hopefully she'll give them to me in exchange for a piece of chicken. Maybe? Are we getting there? There we go, good girl. An incredible little bird. And one more thing as well that you may have noticed. She closes over a third eyelid in order to protect her eyes. So if she were to pick up a snake or a fish or a mouse or whatever it may be, she'll hit it really hard off something. And if she were to flip debris up into her eyes, that could obviously cause issues. So she closes over what is essentially goggles, inbuilt goggles, to protect her eyes. I mean, nature is incredible.
Just one more thing before we lose you. We'll be flying again for you at 2 o'clock, okay? But we won't be flying in here. It's a completely different demonstration. I'm ready for my close-up, Mr. DeVille.
Kick off the show with a British bird who you should all recognise. However, if you haven't seen a wild barn owl before, there's one in front of you who's about to give you a beautiful demonstration. Mm-hmm.
hill, just going over to your right hand side. And she's about 9 or 10 years old now, and she's absolutely wonderful.
Now what we expect from Harriet is pretty much exactly what he's doing today. He's doing a fantastic job of using some nice warm breeze that we're very lucky to have today to soar and glide around in these circuits. He's coming across to the meadow now, because we want him to use those great big wings, they're like sails, to allow him to get up to great heights. This is exactly how step eagles will fly in the wild. So you can have a reward for that, my boy. Brakes! Well done. As I say, he's 4 years old and he's still relatively in training, if you like. So we don't really ask Harriet to do too much work at all. In actual fact, just a couple of flights from him a day gives you an opportunity to see an eagle fly and teaches him a lot. He comes out here and flies like that, and I give him a great big reward for doing it. He's going to think, okay, well, tomorrow I'm going to do exactly the same thing again, and he'll get better and better and better.
Ash, the baby great Grail, he's actually just about to turn 1 year old. So he is just a big baby, although he has really grown. So when I say the baby, he won't get any bigger than this. Good boy. Well done. That does round off our demonstration for this afternoon.